When she heard the noises coming from the house's walls, she realized the reason behind them. There's always that one house in a neighborhood that everyone talks about. A similar thing happened in Germantown, Tennessee. There were rumors that one house was haunted, but in reality, something entirely else was the case. Something that would shock the whole world. The homeowners started hearing an unusual sound every now and then. However, the sound gradually became more frequent until the owners started hearing it non-stop. Then they knew they had to do something. Little did they realize that this would change their home for good. Keep listening to find out more about something incredibly strange that was lurking behind the walls of one home. These homeowners lived in what they thought was just an ordinary house. Their home is located in Germantown, a small but friendly town where everyone talks to everyone. In addition, the house was in a desirable neighborhood. This family was really glad they live in Tennessee. However, when this family purchased the home, they weren't aware that later on they'd have to do so much work to be able to live peacefully inside it. Shortly after moving in, a weird noise started haunting them. The house was a bit older, so the family expected to hear some noises throughout it. They got used to the occasional creaking sounds and similar noises, but this particular one was something they never heard before. The family was happy with their home despite its age. There are plenty of charming historic homes in Germantown, and people tend to renovate them so they can make them appealing again. But what was the noise inside this home? The first time this family heard a strange noise in their home, they thought it wasn't a big deal. They'd hear it every now and then, and additionally, when one person heard it, the others didn't, so they thought it was nothing to worry about. Then all the family members started noticing the sound. First, it would appear rarely, but then it started happening more frequently. Usually, when you hear a noise inside your home, you can figure out what it is. Sometimes we hear water dripping or a creak, but it was impossible for these homeowners to figure out what this bizarre sound was. Not only were they unable to identify it, but they also couldn't find where it was coming from. It seemed the noise traveled around the home. Soon, things would get even worse. At first, the noise was heard every now and then. However, later on, it became incessant. The homeowners knew they had to do something. It was impossible to live in a home knowing there was something weird going on. The owners were really worried the noise was maybe lurking behind the walls and could do some serious damage. After trying to figure things out, they got an interesting idea. There was only one way to find out where it was coming from. Sometimes a mouse or a rat can get stuck in the walls. When that happens, homeowners hear a distinctive clicking noise. However, these homeowners were quite sure the noise didn't come from a rodent. And if it was a rodent, then there had to be plenty of them stuck in the walls. Maybe there was an entire rodent family? The homeowners didn't want to have any chances, so they were determined to get rid of them for good. As soon as they became worried, the family called pest control to their rescue. After some time, they were able to locate where the noise was coming from. This made it easier for the pest controller to get the pesticide into the walls of the house. The company came to the home, marked the walls, and put as much pesticide as possible inside, hoping it would kill the rodents or at least make them escape. However, nobody was sure what exactly was inside the walls. And to the disappointment of the entire family, the pest control company didn't help out at all. The annoying noise was still there. The homeowners would hear it all the time and they were sick of it, but they didn't know what to do next. If pest control didn't help, what else could? The family was starting to lose hope. They didn't know how to identify the problem or solve it. Luckily, they came up with something else soon. Since pesticide couldn't help them resolve their problem, the family started thinking that their house might be haunted. Whatever was making the noise should have been killed by the pesticide. Of course, this sounds a little bit unreal, but the family was out of options, and they weren't sure what to do even if the house was haunted. Maybe holy water would help? Seemed as if there were no escaping the noise. Whatever was in those walls, it was alive. The homeowners knew they would have to make it leave no matter what it was. If it was a ghost, making it leave would be a bit more problematic, right? Nothing made sense anymore. If it was an animal, the pest control should have killed it no matter what. But the pesticide didn't work. So if this wasn't a solution, then what could it be? The homeowners realized there was no way their home was haunted. Something else must be causing all this trouble, so they turned to Google for help and started looking for new solutions. Of course, Google pointed out dozens of possible problems and solutions for each. The family started reading posts on a few forums, determined to find out what was going on. As it turned out, the noise in the intruder the family was dealing with was unique. No user could figure out what the noise was or where it was coming from since the owners themselves were unsure. So they realized they'd try to describe the sound as specifically as possible. The next step was to wait for the noise to appear so that all family members could hear it at the same time. They sat down for a few hours and remained quiet until they could figure it out and turn to the forums again. The noise was louder than ever before and it sounded as if something quite big was causing it. When the homeowners heard the noise at the same time, they agreed that the noise reminded them of almost some sort of vibration. Something living was causing this vibration, and now it seemed the thing in their walls was more alive than ever before. The family had to figure this out as soon as possible. A few moments later, the noise became much clearer and was some sort of vibration combined with a buzz. That's when the homeowners realized they were in quite an unusual situation. Now they decided to go and spend some time in the yard. No, they didn't go outside to get some rest. Instead, they wanted to make sure they were correct about the sound this time. The homeowners went out and approached a wall. They believed the sound was coming from it, and they were right. However, not only did they hear the sound clearly now, but they also saw a little bug crawling around the window. Was this an ordinary bug? Yeah, of course it was. Apparently, one little bee was crawling on the wall and then snuck in. The family now realized they might be having a bee problem, and they wanted to call someone to help them out. After searching the internet for some time, they finally found a local man that could help him. His name, David Glover. Don't worry, the homeowners didn't want to kill the bees. If the bees were truly the cause of the weird buzzing sound, they wanted to get rid of them without doing any harm. And there was no one better for this task than David Glover. If you ever have a bee problem, David is the one you'll want to call. Many people think that if there are bees intruding in your home, you should call pest control to get rid of them. On the contrary, you should call someone like David to help you resolve this issue in a completely different way. Bees are on their way to become an endangered species, so killing them would be a big mistake. David Glover is the man who rescues bees. He goes into other people's homes, gets the bees out, and then finds a new home for them. David Glover is also known as the Bee Whisperer, and getting his nickname because he does something that's very different and also dangerous. Imagine handling hundreds of bees and removing them. His hard work definitely pays off. Once he rehomes the bees, he gets some honey in return, which he sells. In addition, he offers something called bee venom therapy. Well, that's enough about David. Would he agree to help this family out? Just because the homeowner saw a few bees around a window didn't mean they had a bee problem. There were a few more checks that needed to be done before they could finally be determined whether bees were taking over the home. David knew no one was more suitable for the job than himself, so he decided to pay the homeowners a visit. Only when he checked out the home in person would he know the truth. When the homeowners called David, they complained about an unusual buzzing sound that was bothering them for quite a while. They described it as something more than just a buzz. The sound was more like an overwhelming swarm. The homeowners worried that if the bees were really stuck inside their walls, they could be in danger. In addition, they were worried the bees might ruin their home. David didn't hesitate for a second, and he decided immediately that he would help the family out. The situation they described sounded very familiar, and David knew what he had to do next. David wanted to calm down the homeowners and check the home out himself. Only by checking out the walls in person could he determine whether they were bees or not, so he decided to pay the homeowners a visit. David packed the one thing he always brings to work, his bee suit. Apparently, this piece of equipment tends to shock everyone once David puts it on. However, he can't do his job properly without it. Even though David is amazing at his job, he doesn't have superpowers. In order to see whether or not there are bees inside a wall, he has to use a special gadget, a thermal imaging camera. This special camera helps David see if there's a heat source inside a wall, and when David opens the camera, if the color red shows up, it means the camera detected a heat source. So if there's red in the photo that appears, that means that bees could be hiding inside the wall. This is the only way for David to be entirely sure. Now we get to the part where it gets kind of insane. When David pulled out his camera, not only did one wall light up, but the entire house. The color red was all over the camera, and even David was a bit shocked. He couldn't find a spot which the bees used to get in. When he took a closer look, though, he noticed the heat source was leading to a small weep hole, which was the result of how the house in the south breathed due to the humidity. The hole must have been their entry point. When David paid attention to the camera, he knew there was only one answer. The homeowners definitely had a bee problem, but once he took into consideration how the house was built, David knew it was going to be a big project for him. David wanted to help the homeowners, but he wasn't sure how to do that. It seemed like there were so many bees, and since the house was built out of brick, it would be very hard for David to find the exact location of the hive. Luckily, David is one hell of a bee man. Once he realized how many bees could be stuck in the walls, he knew he had to do something. Not only were the bees disturbing the homeowners, but they were stuck inside the walls, and their lives were in danger as well. David decided he'd relocate them. However, he had a condition, and the homeowners had to agree to it. In order to extract the bees, David knew he had to do some damage to the home, and of course he wouldn't do it without approval. His job was getting the bees out safely, but luckily the homeowners agreed. The poor family was so sick of hearing the constant buzzing sound that they agreed to have some of their walls demolished. This was going to cost them a bit, but the homeowners would do anything to be peaceful again. David was excited because he wanted to help the homeowners and the bees as well. However, he knew in advance this was going to be one of the most difficult bee removals he'd ever done. Usually, the heat sources he came across were much smaller. He knew the hive was quite big and the house would be giving him some trouble. There was so much brick he didn't know what to expect at all. David Glover hated one thing, working with brick. What makes this material specific is that it crumbles and can be very hard to remove. Sometimes trying to remove brick can damage the hive and make the bees very unhappy. In some cases, all the effort can be in vain. So many things can go wrong when dealing with brick, and this house is made entirely of it. David didn't know what he was getting himself into, and the suspense was killing him. David removed the first brick with difficulty, and the removal left him shocked. There was such a small space between the brick and concrete, David thought that once he'd done with removing the bricks, there wouldn't be many bees left to save. Then something surprised him. When he completely removed the brick, he noticed the hive was left untouched. All the bees looked and sounded happy and healthy, and David was now more optimistic. After removing only one brick, David realized it. The house was definitely infested with bees, and the hive was strong and in perfect form. It seemed as if these bees knew what they were doing exactly. David assumed the bees had been there for quite a while. He had no idea how big this hive might actually be. He removed only one brick and it was swarming with bees. David observed the hive and noticed it was in perfect condition. The bees were frantic and he knew there would be many more of them. There were already so many bees flying around him. At this point, David realized that removing the brick would take hours since he had to do it carefully. He managed to remove only one and wasn't sure what removing the others would be like. David had been in the bee business for quite a while, however, he wasn't able to estimate how far the beehive would go and how long it would take him to remove all the bees to safety. He knew that this would be one of the most interesting projects ever for him. The fact David had no way to know how much brick he'd have to remove, the homeowner started worrying the entire project would cost them a fortune. They weren't sure whether to proceed or not. It took David quite some time to remove the bricks and reach the hive. He had to be extremely careful and remove the bricks one by one. He had to do this so he wouldn't hurt or anger the bees. Imagine if he caused a swarm in the neighborhood. Of course, he also kept the homeowners in mind. It would have been easier to simply smash the bricks, however, he kept their expenses and the structure of the home in mind as well. After working for hours, David managed to remove two full lines of brick. He thought that this would be enough to get all the bees out, however, he was shocked to see that the hive was still as full now as it was when the first brick was removed. This only meant that there was more work to be done. At this point, the buzzing sound became very intense. David knew the bees weren't pleased by the fact that someone was invading the home. After some time, David managed to remove the five lines of brick. Things started getting very interesting, noticing that there were seven narrow honeycombs, which made the starting point of the settlement of these bees. The five lines of brick might have been enough, but David decided to keep going. This was going to be the most insane project he'd ever done. David was a bit excited when he saw the hive kept getting bigger and bigger, even if it meant more hard work for him. He realized the bees were stuck in the walls for far too long and he was happy to help him out. However, dealing with a hive this big, David worried he wouldn't have enough supplies to get all the bees home safely. Were there really so many bees inside the walls? David Glover never imagined that rehousing the bees could turn into such a massive project. He had so much experience with bees that he thought of himself as a bee whisperer. However, he'd never dealt with something this massive before. Luckily, he was prepared and knew what to do. What makes David so special and good with bees is that he knows how to make them stay calm. It takes a lot of calmness and bravery to work with bees and not freak out. Fortunately, David has one special item that helps him out. A lot of people wonder how David isn't afraid of getting stung by bees. That's because he has a special bee suit. The suit covers and protects his entire body, but still, bees do sometimes get in and sting him. The more you get stung by bees, the less you become sensitive. Even if a bee does sting David, it doesn't hurt as much as it did in the past. Sounds pretty cool, right? While David was removing the bricks so he could get to the hive, one peculiar thing happened. A dozen bees landed on David's shoulder and started making their home right on the spot. That's how comfortable David was around the bees. Some of the bees even started flying around his head and buzzing in his ear. For David, this was the only relaxing music that helped him pass the time while he was trying to remove the bees. The buzzing sound or the bees don't bother him anymore, and he even enjoys their company. The majority of people are afraid of bees, and that's perfectly normal. David, on the other hand, loves bee company. For him, bees are fascinating creatures, and he frequently posts about bees on his social media account so he could learn more about them. Did you know that without bees, life on Earth would be impossible? If they didn't pollinate plants, then none of them would be able to grow. Without bees, we would lose a third of our food. After working for hours, David finally removed all the bricks. The sight left him shocked. He called this honeycomb the Holy Huge Honeycomb. The hive was incredibly large in size, and he was shocked the bees managed to survive for so long in there. The discovery meant a lot to all of David's followers on social media, too. They'd never seen a hive this big, and they were all just as excited as David that the bees would finally get a new home. Unfortunately, David saw something else that made him a bit sad. As he removed a few more bricks, he saw something that broke his heart. Some pesticide that the pest control used got inside the wall and killed some of the bees. He found a lot of dead bees in a corner of the hive. Luckily, the beeswax managed to prevent the rest of the pesticide from harming the other bees. Even though some were killed, the rest were alive. Among the bees killed by the pesticide was the queen. Without their queen, the rest of the bees can't survive. The queen bee is the only one who keeps the hive in order and encourages repopulation. This was very bad news for the bee whisperer, but he didn't give up. He knew that he could try to make things better, and he started to move the hive. Usually, when the queen dies, the rest of the bees become aggressive and misbehave, but this wasn't the case with this special hive. They were very well-behaved bees, and David started being optimistic about their future. In addition, it seemed that none of the bees died, except those who were harmed by the pesticide. Now, David had high hopes that he could make the hive successful again. One of the most shocking revelations about the unique hive is the size of the honeycomb. Usually, there are plenty of honeycombs that are small in size and broken up, but this huge hive had two enormous honeycombs. This in itself was an incredible achievement, and he had no clue it would turn out to be so big. As David continued to explore, things got even more interesting. Turned out this was the biggest hive and biggest honeycomb that David had ever seen, and he'd been in the bee business for quite a while. People were shocked by this discovery, and the homeowners couldn't believe their eyes. If a honeycomb was that big, then how many bees would David have to relocate? This was the question, and David was eager to find out the answer. After trying to count every single bee, David concluded there were about 35,000 of them. There could have been even 40,000, but counting them precisely was very difficult. This was such an accomplishment for David. However, he was a bit worried that he wouldn't be able to keep them all. Could he capture and keep all the bees? They seemed to be willing to stick close to the hive, but he was still unsure whether or not he would be able to catch them. Luckily, his special equipment makes even the hardest tasks possible. When David transfers the honeycomb, most of the bees will follow him and stick close to the honeycomb. Most of them want to stay with their hive, so this makes it easy for David to capture the vast majority. But there are always stragglers left behind, and David has to be quite creative to transport the bees without harming them. Believe it or not, he manages to do this with one strange household tool. It may be a bit hard to believe, but David uses a vacuum cleaner to capture the bees left behind. However, he makes sure to empty the vacuum and use gentle suction so he wouldn't harm the bees. This way, the bees can breathe and the vacuum actually keeps them protected. The bees that are left behind have to go through some sort of rehab so they could adjust to their new hive. In order to make this happen, David has to put in a lot of time and effort. David uploaded so many photos to his Facebook and everybody loved them. His feed even managed to go viral and Holy Huge Honeycomb even made it to the news. David was starting to become famous. The bees would accept their new home actually. Spreading the news about David's accomplishment helped him to successfully rehab the bees. His new fame allowed him to talk to other bee whisperers and share knowledge regarding bees that didn't have a queen. The first step was getting the bees to accept their new home. Since these bees lived in a tight space for some time, David thought of something that could help them. He decided to move them into a vertical hive and become their beekeeper. He hoped the bees would even make some honey so he could get an additional income. Bees can't produce honey without a queen, so David made sure to find a new one for the hive. He was able to do this by transporting a queen from another hive of his to this one. However, this wasn't an easy task since the bees can reject a new queen. This was the moment of truth for David. Inserting a new queen would determine the fate of his hive. If they accepted her, the hive would survive. David was incredibly worried, and his followers were anxiously waiting for an update. As soon as the new queen was inserted, the new bees became aware of her. They had been without a queen for quite some time, and it was expected that the new one would attract attention. The bees started flying around their new queen, and David observed them nervously. The bees seemed as if they didn't want to have anything to do with the new queen, and David started worrying for both the bees and the queen. If the bees turned against her, David could lose a good queen. But thankfully, it all turned out well. The bees bowed down to their new queen and started getting along well with her. In order to know if the queen was officially accepted, David needed the bees to start laying eggs. Luckily, it didn't take long, and David soon noticed eggs in the honeycomb. This was a very exciting event for David, and all his followers celebrated too. The process of laying eggs is quite interesting. The larvae grow in the honeycomb, and they use a mixture of pollen and honey as their food. This enables them to gradually grow into adult bees. The worker bees do most of the work, and the queen is the one who wants to try to find a moment's rest whenever possible. Soon, David noticed the hive stalled, and he worried that all his effort would be lost. Luckily, bees resumed their duties shortly after, though. Everyone was fascinated by the story of this hive. Not only did they survive being stuck inside a wall, but they also got used to their new home quite quickly. David assumed the hive had been growing in the wall for about 2 years. The homeowners couldn't notice them at first, but as more and more bees joined the hive, the buzzing became louder. Gratefully, the bees started making honey soon. As soon as they began producing, David felt a huge relief. He knew his rehoming job was finally done. This was one of the most challenging rehoming projects he'd ever done. Saving all the bees made David happy, but it also paid off. The bees made so much honey, and David is more than proud to show off his collection. Most people think that pollen is yellow, and that's why honey's yellowish in color as well. But actually, pollen comes in all different colors. All these colors combined together make a beautiful rainbow. David posted a photo of the holy honeycomb bees and then their pollen inside their honeycomb, and the photo blew everyone away. 6 months after David saved the bees, he posted an update on his social media. He let everyone know the bees are doing incredibly well and that they absolutely adore their new queen. All the worker bees want to get close to her. While the homeowners hoped that they'd never have to deal with bees in their walls again, they were really happy that now their former intruders are safe and sound. They were even proud of themselves because they did help David find and save the bees.